Okay. So getting back to where we were. That's pretty amazing. I know people were making a game out of trying to see how low their skill could go, so. Yeah, right. It's okay. Somebody want to recap again for the stream? Just. To be fair, I'll give that to you. You did. I don't think I gave in so much as just stopped correcting you. But there's not much of a difference. But it's a matter of pride, I think, for me. No, it is difficult terrain. One of them seems to be a squad leader, if you will. I'll give that to you, sure. Yes, yep. Fair enough. For this scene, at least. Yeah, I didn't bother rolling initiative because we kind of rolled from one scene to another where we had a kind of an established order, so. Yep. Yeah, I figured there was something like that. This falls kind of in a gray area in between, which I think most campaigns would end up. Yeah. Bad pun. No, you haven't. Okay. So you tell them to withdraw behind you? Okay. She's still screaming at them, taunting them, that the best you got, fucking losers. All right. Amdorn, it's your turn. How far can I get? Yeah, you could. Well, I can just move everything down. Actually, I probably should, just for the sake of this battle. The ones that aren't on the main line, I'll just get rid of them, just for clarity's sake. Actually, hang on a second. This is gonna be weird. One, two, three. Oh my gosh. Whoa. That messed things up a little bit. That's all right. Why? Hey, everybody's more or less where they were. Fine. All right. Everybody's kind of more or less where they were. So. Oh, crap. You have a longbow? Oh yeah. Wasn't cutting it. It's lighter. If we were doing encumbrance, not harsh way. Yeah, I should probably make you guys do that. That's stuff that you use every session. All right. So you're drawing your bow and readying an action. Is that what you're doing? No, we're past you, Vathek. No, I'm talking to Amador. It's his turn. Look at the turn tracker. Okay. Well, you you have plenty of targets of opportunity, probably within your range increment, which is 30, right? Okay. That glances off his armor. Oh, roll 20, why are you doing this to me? Okay. Roll 20 keeps messing up on me. I'm sorry, guys. I don't know why. Okay, Magnus. Resting, you here? Well, I mean, isn't a lot of your stuff against touch AC? Okay. So, are you moving at all, Magnus? Okay. Lucius? Resting. Which soldier? Roll 20 is seriously fucking up on me. Or is it Chrome? I don't know what's going on. I've tried it multiple times. Okay. Let's Okay. Yes, you can do that. That's it. Okay. Do a quick roll here. Right, yeah, the soldier brings his shield down on top of the guy and then subsequently drives his short sword into the Lanlinari's throat. Black blood spurts everywhere. Oh yeah, these guys are bleeding black blood. All right, I'm gonna shut down Chrome, guys. I gotta do this. I'll be right back. This is just messing with me. Background Chrome. Okay. Okay, yes. So somebody moved to smush him. Okay, that's fine. Lovely. All right. Well done. All right. Magnus? Lucius. Sorry. Okay, you don't have a reach attack. Okay. Right. Since the line seems to be forming on Vig, she's going to stay where she is. Upside down and all. And ready an attack as well. And she's gonna intimidate. Just kind of shout obscenities at nearby enemies. I'm sorry, guys. Wife is out for the evening, so I gotta go attend to one of the kiddos. I can hear them on the monitor. Be right back. All right, so, guys, sorry about that. I returned. Okay. I blame them too, so it's all good. Okay. Yeah, so Vig's gonna ready an action. And then these guys are going to move. So let's see. Okay, and the Law and the Nari move in. So, Lucius, you're gonna do something. Nope. Vathek, were you gonna take a shot at him? Okay. No, it does not. Yeah, I think you can. Oh, no, no. I thought you. It's not from your. Okay. Okay, no, you cannot. Okay. All right, so he takes a swing at Lucius. Oh, Lucius, what's that for? Your AC? Okay. Yeah, he misses. Okay, so you slip on the rough terrain that you're on, and have to take a knee. So you're at a slight disadvantage for the next guy who comes charging in. Yeah, the rough terrain bites you in the ass. So next guy rushes in. And does a 23 hit? Lucius. Okay. Yes, yes, he does. What's Scald going to do? Okay. Nope. Seems to be 23 seems to be just out of reach. All right, so Lucius, you take 5 damage. All right. Magnus. Magnus, do you have anything ready? Okay. So, Skald, I'm assuming a 15 doesn't hit. Okay. Okay. Yeah, this one does. Fails miserably. Okay. Vig is going to attack this guy. And she misses by a narrow margin. But he is going to take a swing at Chompy. Does a 22 hit. Chompy. Okay. Right. He takes 4 damage. And get the guy attacking Vig. And all right, she takes some damage. And we got one last guy charging in, and he's going to get provoke an attack of opportunity because he's moving through. Actually, he'll move through to here. From just Vig. Oh, and yeah, so he manages to charge in, basically leaps in with a short sword and a dagger in hand, and just kind of burrows them both into the chest of the into the breastplate of the guy in, the dude. this guy rushes in, but he doesn't get a chance to attack because he didn't have a direct line in, and that wasn't a charge, so. And I'll just fill this in real quick. And we're back to Vathek. Yeah, that hits. No, he's toast. It was a brutal exchange. At the front line. You should be able to. She's behind Caragor. She's got a health bar there. For the guy immediately in front of him. Okay. Okay. That's a hit. Many shot doesn't trigger on covering fire, does it? Okay. That's fine. Okay. He's hanging on by a thread. Okay. Yeah, he's toast. Okay. Three hits. Okay. 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 Alrighty. And Amadorn. Okay. Essentially. Yes. Okay. Magnus. Fair enough. Sorry. Okay. So you're not making any attacks, Magnus? Okay. Lucius. Does what is what? So you essentially you're essentially prone, but you don't take any penalties for standing back up again. Like you don't provoke attack at the opportunity for standing up again. What's that? Sure. Okay. The guy, the one on the left. Okay. So yeah, 28 hits him. Okay. The one you didn't. Okay. You're gonna provoke? All right, that's two of them you're provoking. Okay. And you are vindicated because they both had horrible, horrible rolls. So, single digit. So. Okay. yeah, one of them tries to climb up onto the rubble pile and falls on his face. All right, Vig. is going to take a withdraw action as well. And she's going to move back here. Okay. And so the other soldiers, they're going to take the ones in the front. I'm going to back up and take 5 foot steps to do in ready actions. And that just leaves Karior out in front to get. Okay, let me roll for Caragor here. Yep. I shit you not, I got two crits. It's in his job description. So he takes 13, actually, he takes 21 from one hit. Okay. And he takes 12 from the other. Okay. Okay. The and the others on the line actually miss. So, Vathek, it is your turn. They don't appear to be. Okay. I think you can drag it out onto the board and I can claim it. that might kill him. Which one? Okay. 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 Yeah, you just don't get the get to make a move action in the same round you do a 5 foot attack, 5 foot step. Yeah. Okay. Amador. See anything on the left or the right? Actually do see a guy hurrying down the street. He's dressed in purple robes, and he's carrying, like, he's got scrolls, like, he's got scrolls and scroll casings, bundled up in his arms. He's dropping them, he's stopping to pick them up. He's got like a pack slung over his back, full, like, that spills out when he stoops to pick up a scroll. And do you have a, like a knowledge local or anything? Yes, you're familiar that with the fact that it's probably a man. Sure, sounds about right. Okay. He looks relieved. He's like, "Oh, thank the makers that there's somebody here who appreciates my work." Am a collector of knowledge. I'm a historian. Okay, next, Magnus. Amador, and you're over here now. Okay. You can reach 15 feet. Okay. CMD. Okay. Yeah, he's prone. Okay. One of them gets in an attack. Okay, he does some damage. Oh, and this guy is close to toast anyway, so he gets finished off. Dokie. 12 misses. Okay. Lucius. Okie dokie. Vig is going to step back and ready an attack. And the men make their withdrawals. Oh, I'm going to add a turn for them. Just fucking dragon, that's right, yeah. He fucked a dragon. What's that? Yeah. Is that what? I think that's actually me the one messing up my. No, I'm serious. I think the FX are like, what messed up my roll 20? Ah, fuck me. All right, hang on. Fucking Chrome. I think I'm gonna have to find a way to disable those. Yeah. No, surprisingly, there is no disable FX. I mean, it probably works fine in Firefox, because Firefox supports everything that Chrome doesn't now. Well, yeah. Bells and whistles. Yes, indeed. Yeah, 'cause oh, fuck, really? Why are you doing this to me? You guys see that shape I just drew? I have no idea. This is part of the problem. God. Okay, so far so good, I think. All right, I'll cross my fingers. No fireballs. Okay. Okay, now time for these guys to charge in. Vig's got two coming at her. She takes a, well, she withdrew, so that didn't count. Chompy did ready it in action. Is that right? Chompy can attack the guy that moved in on his left. Actually twice because he, I guess, moved through a threatened square. He also provoked an attack of opportunity. From Chompy, because Chompy threatened this square. Chompy. Still sneezing. Yeah, he also provoked an attack of opportunity. Okay. All right, that's a hit. Yeah, but you can do a readied action and then an attack of opportunity. So that's a hit. Okay. Well, no, he's dead because he's taken damage before. All right. Another one charges in. Attack Vig. Right. Vig takes a little bit of damage. Magnus, you don't have anything ready, do you? Okay. Caragor, does he have anything ready, or did he withdraw? Okay. Skald, do you have anything ready? Okay. Lucius, do you have anything readied? It does. It does not. Okay. Let's see, we got a few rolls to make here. Skald does a 23 hit. And Lucius does a 24 hit. Okay, so Skald, you take 3. Lucius, you take 5. Yeah, you got blood pouring out of, a couple of slashes on your body, maybe one across the cheek. It's all very dramatic. Yeah. Vathek, you're up. I think Lucius still has all his stress boxes, though. That's a hit. The guy directly in front of Lucius. Okay. Wolf on the right is sculled. It's hard to keep track of this in the heat of battle, so. You can make a perception check to try and divine this. Are you feeling okay, Vathek? Wait, hold on. How did you make a second attack? The 17? Okay. Okay. Yep, no, I'm tracking. I'm tracking. I'm good. Okay. I thought that was until the end of your turn. Or this. Well, yeah. Yeah. Okay, that's misses all around. Couple of glancing blows off of Caragor's thick hide. Right. Why ever let you put barding on that thing? I don't know. lessons learned. Okay. Amadorn. Oh, well, there a few of them are my humble works and but many of them are the works of great authors. You might recognize them as well, there's Gerard Imdar, the he wrote the History of Non-Dwarven Peoples. It's a masterpiece. Says, "Oh, they're priceless." I couldn't even think to. All right, this is not actually him, but I'm gonna use this token because it seems to fit right now. All right, my wife just walked in the door. I'm gonna say hello to her and refresh my drink. Since we're at a amusing point, so I'll be right back. Call it a 5 minute break. And I'm back. Hello. No, he's more concerned about carrying the history of non-dwarven peoples by Garad Imdar. It's pretty pervasive. I'd say it's more of a radiant effect. Okay, yeah, it's an aura. Yeah, maybe Amadorn should share his scroll. See if he remains boring. All right, Magnus. Vathek, while he's thinking that over, roll a 1d6. Okay. Okay. Yeah, he remains untripped. You're one. Okay. Fair enough. Yeah, that's a miss. Okay. Okay. All right. Chompy. You get two, actually, because there's the one next to him. No, he's standing on top of a dead man. Yeah, sorry, you should be careful of that. I've been pushing the dead ones to the back so I can stack on top of them. That's all right. Chumpy could use a little bit of. Oh, okay. I rolled a crit, so 20 damage to Chompy. Okay. Lucius. Yeah, he's already attacked. Okay. All right, following form, Vig is going to attack the one on the left. And this guy's pretty well damaged, but she's going to provoke an attack of opportunity from him anyway. Oh, she takes damage. Okay. And we're on to our the guy on the left shores up his line a little bit. Just takes a 5 foot step and readies an action. So hopefully the wizard doesn't get slaughtered. And this guy's gonna move back one. All right. It is, which is why I'm bringing in reinforcements here. All right. So, this guy is definitely toast. This one is toast as well. This guy takes a pretty good gash. Say he's not doing so hot. and this guy in the end here gets offed. feet long, maybe. Yeah. It's all right. For convenience, we'll do medium for this because he squeezes through tight holes. That too. Let's see. You can make a perception check. Actually, there actually aren't that many that are wounded. They've either fallen back or fallen. But this guy over here is on his last legs. Okay. That's it. Okay, so he's toast. Okay. Nope, you got it. Don't even bother rolling damage. Okay. Caragor. We can move up onto the dead bodies. Okay. Okay. Amadorin. I'm sure they would. I mean, it's self-evident how valuable these things are to our society. I am among the most important of the scholarly class here. He trudges along behind you. Magnus. All right. So two attacks of opportunity on him. Okay, one of them connects and does quite a lot of damage. And he's prone. So, okie-dokie. It's Golden Chompy. Yeah, Austin Tucker is like probably 50 feet behind you, trying to usher. Yeah. I mean, he's been going back and forth and doing a lot of other things. Well, fuck this place. Okay. That was a 10-foot step, or that's a miss. Lucius. Oh, I'm sorry, Skull. Okay. Okay. Look at you guys forming a tight line there. Okay. Vig shout, "Come at me, you pale fuck faces!" and readies her attack. Which is not dissimilar to why the Lanlinari are called the Grey Elves, because they are donning mud on their faces to look gray. And the Pale Reavers go back quite a ways, so there may be some kind of connection. So. Right, so. With a, let's see, 1, 2, 3, one, okay. Caragor left out in the open again. I mean, it's they don't have a choice. At the same time, just in a brief, there's a brief lull in sort of the press of Lanlinari behind. So they may be intimidated enough to try and go around him. So. This guy stands up. So this guy is now no longer prone, just for the record. All right, Scald, did you have a okay. Magnus, you didn't have an attack you could do. Okay. All right, you got at least one moving through your threatened spaces there, Caragor. Oh man. Well, he actually would have moved through Caragor's prepared action and then through a threatened space. So if you want to take another stab at him, all right. Well, the one kind of cancels that out. So. Okay, and while Caragor is distracted, he kind of gets surrounded. He calls that Tuesday. Okay. All right, yeah, so this guy in front takes some serious damage. This guy over here. I'm talking about. Vig levels some serious rage onto one of these guys. Sends him to his maker. Jumpy, did you have something at the ready? Lucius? Okay. Vathek, did you have something at the ready? No, you had. Okay. All right, Scald. Okay. Now, text on Caragor. Okay. Right, one regular hit and one crit. Regular hit is 13. Crit is 21. All right, so I'm going to clean up the battlefield a little bit here. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Right, when I mentioned a lull, there actually is sort of a gap in the forces because there's just you guys have been slaughtering them for quite a while, and there's other things that are drawing their attention in other parts of the city. Yes. And you've kind of exhausted sort of the squads that have been tasked to go down this one particular alley, more or less. For, I mean, there's obviously more pouring in, but this is there is an immediate threat. It was just like a temporary lull in the stream of Lanlinari pouring forward. Okay, Vathek, you're up. He can withdraw directly through Magnus and the guy behind him. But he would provoke attacks of opportunity from four of them. Five of them, actually. Well, so withdraw makes him go move through this square, unprovoked, but this square is actually covered by four. And then this square is covered by two, but they would have already evacuated. So, I mean, you've kind of got to carve out a wider path. Yeah, where you start is not considered threatened. So, basically, where he is, it would be fine, and then the next square would be fine. It's just when he gets to here, he could actually withdraw and stop in front of Magnus. And not provoke any attacks of opportunity, but then he would get all those attacks on him, kind of pig piled. You can do that in 5 foot step. You can do that in 5 foot step. Basically, the five in front of Caragor are the five you want to get out of the way if Caragor is going to withdraw. I mean, you could say Caragor is going to go on Vig's turn if you want to wait to see who who else falls. You're about to provoke two, actually. Which one? Okay. And you take 10 damage. Okay. This guy. What does entangling shot do again? Knocks him prone. Okay. Fair enough. All right. Are you going to hold Caragor's action or? Okay. Amador. Well, he's still got a lot of in his own possession. Okay. Oh yeah, he's like looking pretty panicked. You know, he's casting wistful glances back in the direction of what you would assume would be his library. Try not to die. Sounds good. No, I don't believe so. I don't know. Don't know. I think, well, maybe I'm wrong. That seems pretty specific in the way it's worded, so. Well, I mean, he's at least at a minus two to attack, if not more, depending on what kind of attack it is. 26. Okay. Magnus, what are you doing? Well, I mean, as it stands now, if Caragor withdraws, he's provoking two attacks of opportunity. He's seen worse. The one adjacent to you and the one, yes, just below him. All right. Trip doesn't l eliminate his attack of opportunity, it just makes it awful. Okay. That's a hit. Nope, he's not dead. Okay. Wait, you can do two trips? Oh, you're not moving. Okay. okay, Lucius. There you go. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, yeah, so 26 does hit. And this just you were attacking the guy adjacent to you. Lucius, you were attacking the guy to your southwest. Okay. All right. Vig, seeing that the line is holding for the moment, attacks the guy in front of Chompy. And quite simply eviscerates him. All right. Caragor. He can't go through the entangled guy. He could, so there's the tripped guy can actually. Yeah. Well, they're at minus four, I think. So. Yeah, they both miss by a wide margin, so. Okay. All right. So the yeah, your fellow guards move back, and the Lan Lanari actually think better of fighting you at the moment, and most of them take a step back, except for the one guy who tries to get to his feet in front of Skuld and Magnus. So, he would provoke an attack of opportunity. Getting to his feet is his move action, so he can't really do anything else. This guy is no longer entangled. Okay. So these guys are going to move up, and so basically you draw them to a temporary stalemate and then are able to withdraw back into the inner keep, where there are more guards waiting, and you're able to pull back behind the line if you like for a brief respite. Your party shrunk a little bit. Vathek, roll another D6. Again with the four. Okay. You did. He was actually the sergeant in front of in charge of these men. And you get back to the line, and Durr is there, treating others who are coming off the line, and just sort of guarding the escape of everyone down into the catacombs. And you, I mean, so there's not a lot of points of ingress into the inner keep. There's this gate, and there's one other gate, and the other gate is closed, and there's men up on the wall, who are attempting to mount a sort of stodgy defense with rocks and arrows that they've scrounged, but it's there's not a lot of stuff left to throw down upon the guys who are sieging the inner keep. And so it's really down to the line that you helped establish at the open gate. And pretty soon they'll be able to breach it with, ladders and stuff on other sides, but for now it's a good egress for everyone who remains in the inner keep, which is where the bulk of the remaining civilians were. Sure. We can take. Sure. Yeah, and the guardsman, his name is Vargas. His the sergeant, I should say, in charge of the men. Although some of these guys were probably from different squads initially, but he's taken charge of them. Seems appreciative of the words, and he clasps his hand on your shoulder and says, we would have been lost without you, Pale Reaver. Are these all Pale Reavers? Says, well, thank you. We'll see what the coming days bring for the remnants of Astrakhan. And he starts ushering some of the wounded back towards the catacombs, and tries to make it a reasoned withdrawal. But there's something shaking the ground. And there's sort of a sound of that sort of reminds some of you of a trip off of a mountain. Months ago, where you were part of an avalanche. Some of you were. And it's a sound not dissimilar to that, where there's a good chunk of the wall coming down by the outer wall, and yeah, so Celia had been sent down into the catacombs with Dura and Kaylee. Roderick came back up and hasn't been seen since. So you assume he's been aiding in the defense, and he could be, easily up on the wall or doing something or other that's useful that you would suspect that Roderick would do, but. It's hectic, and so tracking down one man is. They're down in there. Yeah. Yeah, I know. That's. What's your medicine? Okay. You can try and patch up Caragor. Make a roll. No. Okay. Roll 1d4 minus 1. Okay. Caragor gets 0 back. Too bad he's bleeding from his hindquarters. Sure. Okay. All right, make a survival check. And you're on your favorite terrain. You're not gonna tend to your doggies? You're looking for cool stuff. Okay, roll 1d6 plus 3. That's how many arrows you find. Okay. You keep dropping arrows, or you find a quiver with one arrow in it, and you keep bending over to like look at other people, and then you keep thinking that you're picking up one arrow when in fact it's the arrow falling out of the quiver that you picked up. And then after the fifth body that you turn over, you don't notice the arrow falling out, and then you step on it and break it in half. Okay, and Amadorn, you're looting, so roll your most appropriate looting skill. Think looting in most contexts is called stealing, but let's not split hairs. Make a perception check, and you can make a stealth check, Amadorn. Just make a stealth check. Yes. Okay, perception check, Vathek. Don't worry about it. Just don't worry about it. He perceived it. He perceives that you're up to something shady. I'm still trying to decide. Well, you can either do that or give or continue to tend to Caragor. You can only raise his spirits. hang on, I'm going to. I am attempting something here. Hang on. The clinical term. Anything worth money? Okay. Let me see here. Well, you did find a small shrine. So Astrakhan is very much a human settlement with human construction, as opposed to areas in the south where you had previously encountered a lot of dwarven influence in the construction. And you find a shrine to some dwarven, modern dwarven gods, which are not unlike modern human gods, which these are, dwarves of the striking of iron, or gods of the striking of iron, or gods of the, the growing of fungus. You know, they're, I mean, like they're just they're kind of inane compared to the old gods. But you do find a hand axe. Sort of on this altar, in the shrine, that looks like it's old dwarven construction, if nothing else, and probably worth a pretty penny. I mean, you're pretty sure that if you left it there, that the Londonari would take it, and there's no dwarves in sight that would object to you taking it. So, okay. You're not sure. That would be in your wheelhouse, so sure. Okay. All right, let me hang on a second. Okay. So this is a Nurian silver dwarf axe. Oh, I'm sorry. No. This is a Thundersteel dwarf axe. Basically it does 1d6 plus 3 damage. For all intents and purposes, it's a masterwork, but it's not a plus one or anything. But essentially, the critical on it is times three, as with any other hand axe. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. No, so it does 1d6 plus 3 damage. So that's about it. You can it's good for throwing, good for hacking. So Thundersteel. It's worth a lot, if nothing else. You notice Amadorn looking shady. Yep. So, Amadorn, you notice a Pale Reaver captain looking at you just as you're tucking this into your pack and. Yeah. So the it is not exactly an ideal place to hang out at the moment because the well, basically, Austin Tucker is walking up and down the line right now, and he's saying, "Everyone, get to the catacombs if you can right now. We're gonna pull back." Yeah, but he pretty much ignored it. Yeah. So, he's encouraging. It would be a nice way of putting it. Who are you asking? There's a couple of guys near you, but you're probably. Probably. Okay. Okay. Go ahead. No, a goddess of luck would be would certainly be a common goddess. Okay. Yeah, so her name is Jiri. Yeah, Jyri. Okay. Yeah, so the there's a line that forms sort of at the base of the stairs of the catacombs, a little bit back so that they can't just take pot shots down the stairwell at people. It's a more or less, controlled withdrawal, similar to what you were affecting. And you do manage to get yourselves down into the catacombs, and the air is tight and cloying around you, and it's narrow in places, and there's not a lot of people, a lot of room for people to take any sort of respite. Dura is doing her best to tend wounds where she can, but even getting somebody under some decent light to, even do some triage is proving difficult. So Captain Tucker walks up by Vathek and taps him on the shoulder and says, yeah, so this is going to be a an interesting road through here. There's parts of these catacombs that we simply don't go in anymore. Not even our priests. They've been sealed. And it's the Ravenholm district, that's right. There's parts of these catacombs where we're not sure where the if there is even a way out, but tale has it that there's a forest on the other side, and Lord knows that there's not a forest for miles, so we could be under here for quite a while. Says, I'm hoping we can find a decent source of water while we're under here, because we are woefully ill prepared for this. He says, but I count 60 men under my command to hold as a rear guard, but I'm hoping that you can press forward as my forward scouts, and we can make our way through these catacombs. Okay. Right. Tucker pauses and then chuckles. He says, my idiot brother-in-law is proving his worth, I guess. And then he surveys his troops and looks at Dura, who's doing some of the mending, and shakes his head and says, "Well, surely a lot of these men owe you their lives, and I don't think there's time to properly appreciate it. But know that if any of us make it out of here alive, you'll be remembered." Wow. Didn't think you mercenaries were optimists. He chuckles and walks away. Right. Anyone else want to get anything else in before we end the session? All right. Yeah, okay. Fair enough. Cool, guys. Well, thanks for the session. You each get, we'll call that 1600 XP. Well, we'll have a change of scenery for the next time, and looking forward to the next question. Yeah. Okay. So they were sort of the back and forth between the different artillery pieces. Sure. And the D6s were sort of your roles to for the NPCs that were off screen, sort of how they were faring. So. Amadorn got to do a little thieving and. He made it down to the catacombs with you. Well, you know, he had a lot to keep track of, so his accounts of the Old Kingdom slash fiction. We'll see you next time. All right. Thanks, guys. This was fun. All right. Later.